The most important thing to remember in human design, the human design system, the science of differentiation, is that you are utterly unique. And in discovering your differentiated projector frequency, we're looking at strengths that make a projector what it is. And everything for the projector is about guiding the other. So I decided to start with my own channel to be able to explain a little bit about how that frequency can show up. And this is about being a creative role model, a creative expression of an identity that leads by example. So if you have a 1-8, or if you see somebody has a 1-8, and I'm speaking specifically to projectors, so I'm going to use the keynotes of projectors. So they may or may not have other channels defined in the body graph, but individually as a strength, this inspirational frequency is off and on. It does not have any awareness. It's a mechanism. It's a mechanism of leadership. So the way that I found myself expressing my role, my contribution, my teaching, my identity, just naturally gravitated to being recognized and invited by Jovian Archive, BG5, IHDS, all these people that said, we have to find a place for this person because this channel attracts attention. Now, if you look at what a projector is, we're designed to attract attention, but that attention is only attracted to us if we are operating in alignment. Not in alignment, what happens? Bitterness, resentment. Is that attractive? Hell no. People will usually run the other way. So this expression of a unique identity had to be gestated through my decision-making strategy applied over years. I was not inspired or inspirational in the beginning of my human design experiment. In fact, I was very depressed. I was self-medicating with not only before human design, before I even met my husband, I was self-medicating with my ex-husband's drugs. He was pushing his pills on me and I was taking them like a good girl, thinking that that would help because I really gave over my authority to my ex-husband. And it took years, 3.5 years, for this frequency to clean itself off enough to be able to inspire anybody, to be able to even come forth from me. I went and looked back at my timestamps for the videos that I've posted on YouTube, and it started about 5 years ago. That was 2015. And I found human design in 2012. So it took years to get to this place of being able to express any kind of unique perspective on the system, human design. So the potential here is to guide creative inspiration by being an example. Now, the other channel that I have, the potential to guide clarity through the recognition of feelings, this is a design of focused recognition. What is it recognizing? Feelings. It's recognizing the pressure to experience a feeling. It has the hunger, the drive to imagine, to fantasize, to feel something deeply in order to learn and grow. So because this is where my sun shines, the 30, and it's a third line, and it's a third color, it is about having the desire to be a leader when it comes to recognizing what fate feels like when it steps in, when it kicks you in the ass, and when your emotions cloud your judgment. So being able to share my experiences, you hear me very honestly sharing things like, oh my God, I couldn't imagine how to get out of this relationship except for to kill this person. You know, my mind would fantasize about all kinds of really horrible things. This mind can fantasize about anything, particularly sexually. And to recognize that there was nothing wrong with me, that that was part of my uniqueness, was a huge wake-up call, or a hurdle overcoming the stuff about myself I felt very shamed and guilty and depressed and embarrassed about, because I thought I was such a freak. You know, I felt like there was something deeply, deeply wrong with me at the beginning of the experiment. So when we start to look at all of these strengths, the way that they can show up is a this and a that. It can show up disempowered here, Or it can show up empowered. At the beginning of the human design experiment, if you're an adult and you haven't had the chance to decondition and you're living very much in the not self, you are deeply disempowered. And you might be deeply depressed because of that. And you can't empower anybody else unless you yourself are empowered. So this is what I see out there happening in the world with all of these projectors going, oh, let me guide you. And they might be trying to guide somebody to make money, but they're freaking broke. They're broke as hell. How can they think that they can be able to guide somebody to make money if they're not already successful themselves? It's the mind's process thinking, if I just take this other person's system and if I teach it, then they're going to be able to get that person's results. Hell no. Everybody on this planet is here to have a unique expression of themselves, and we can't take a system that is applied across the board to everybody at large. It has to be unique and differentiated. And so this is part of my expression to you of me learning how to use the language in more and more precise ways that gets you to the heart of the truth of what you are for yourself. Even though I just explained to you what my design, the individual nature of my channels, my strengths, the life force, where I'm here to be uniquely different, I express to you my generalities of what these channels are in the expression of my uniqueness, and I don't have time to go into all of the different nuances and subtleties of how it shows up, but the more that you differentiate, the more unique this frequency gets, the more precise your ability to guide the other to success becomes. So as I go through the rest of these channels, I'm going to do my best. I don't have them, but I'm going to do my best to explain to you what they can show up like.